Hey, what's up YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. It's Christine with Gage Girl Training, an online meal planning and coaching service. In today's video, we're gonna talk about my top 20 healthy food swaps. So let's get started. So if you've been following this channel for any length of time, you'll know that living a healthy lifestyle can be quite complex when it comes to the nutrition and the science and the macros and all those things. But in this video, we're gonna do something a little bit different, and I'm going to talk about 20 simple things that you can do to make your life a little bit healthier in an easy everyday fashion. So let's start with number 20. Number 20 is switching out your Sriracha hot sauce for Tabasco sauce. So that may sound kind of crazy, kind of weird. What are you talking about, Christine? Isn't hot sauce healthy? Well, Sriracha does have a little bit more sugar and a little bit more carbs than Tabasco. I call it Tabasco. So switch out your hot sauce for Tabasco. It's a little bit lighter in the calories if you want something a little bit lighter. So number 19, you guys probably won't agree with this, but if you are having an end of the day, you want to swap out that relaxing glass of wine for a glass or a cup of hot tea. Alcohol is probably the worst possible thing that you can be consuming if you are focusing on fat loss. It pauses your body's ability to lose body fat for up to 48 to 72 hours. If you need that like relaxing vibe at the end of a long day, I totally get it. Switch out your vino for a nice cup of aromatic tea. So number 18, simple but profound. Swap out salt for herbs. When you're seasoning your food, you guys, it doesn't always have to be heavy salt. Again, salt isn't bad for you. You still need a little bit of salt in your diet, but there are so many ways to season your food with herbs that can make it taste amazing, like basil, thyme, oregano, rosemary, cilantro. There's so many fun things that you can do, so try experimenting, especially with fresh herbs. It really makes a difference. So item number 17 is swapping out your soda for sparkling water. If you are still drinking soda, you really need to get on board and just eliminate all of that extra sugar. You don't need it. Obviously, water would be a better choice, but if you just needed something a little bit bubbly, a little effervescent, you can swap out your soda for sparkling water. Item number 16, swapping out potato chips for apples and nut butter. I highly recommend this because chips, yes, it's carbs and fat, and apples and nut butter is carbs and fat too, but you're going to get so many more vitamins, so many more nutrients, and it's actually going to keep you fuller, and you're gonna get a lot more fiber. So skip the chips, you guys. Go for like apples and nut butter. It's a much healthier snack and it tastes just as good, honestly. Number 15, if you're going to Starbucks, skip out on those scones and go for one of those like breakfast egg white spinach feta wraps. They're amazing for breakfast, high in protein, and it's gonna save you significantly on the sugar content. Item number 14 is swapping out M&Ms for almonds, and specifically the peanut M&Ms. So I recommend this because the raw almonds, you guys, are going to contain a lot more fiber. You don't have any of the sugars, any of the colorants, and it's actually going to keep you fuller longer. The next item, number 13, is swapping out salad dressing for a squeeze of lemon. This is one of my favorite tips because sometimes salad dressings can just be so heavy, and you can get a really nice flavor and keep your salad from being overly dry just by squeezing a lemon, squeezing a lime. Another trick, if you absolutely have to have salad dressing, is dipping your fork in the salad dressing and then forking each bite so you get the flavor and taste of salad dressing with every bite without having all of the caloric content. Swapping out pretzels for carrots. If you need a crunch, if you need something to snack on, I actually consider carrots to be a free food. So go for carrots, extremely lighter in calories, and you don't even really need to count them unless you're eating pounds and pounds of carrots, then it becomes a problem. But if you're just eating like a little baggie of carrots, I consider that almost negligible. All right, guys, so item number 11 is swapping out your sugar for monk fruit. Now, if you need to sweeten your coffee, you want to sweeten your protein shake, go for something that is sweetened with monk fruit. It's going to save you a ton of calories. It's probably one of the best tasting natural sweeteners. Highly recommend it. It tastes awesome. So we're item number 10, which is where I recommend swapping out iceberg lettuce for spinach. Now, iceberg lettuce isn't bad for you guys, but spinach and darker leafy greens are going to have so much more minerals, antioxidants, and they're going to pack in way more vitamins and minerals than iceberg lettuce alone. So item number 9, if you are making some protein shakes, if you are doing oatmeal, if you are doing any kind of like healthy baking, I recommend swapping out chocolate chips for cacao nibs. Now, obviously you can still have chocolate chips if you want to, you know, count that into your macros, but cacao nibs are going to have less sugar, they're going to have more antioxidants, more minerals, and they're going to be better for you. So item number 8 is swapping out cereal for oatmeal. It's probably been a hot minute since most of you have had cereal, but I'm not sure. But if your kids are eating cereal, you guys, get them on oatmeal. It's going to have more fiber, it's going to have less sugar, it's going to be a much healthier option. Even if your kids end up having oatmeal with fruit and no added protein, just that alone is going to be so much better than a bowl of just sugary BS. Item number 7, we're in the countdown here, swapping out your syrup. If you have never tried a calorie-free syrup, I highly recommend swapping out a basic pancake syrup for Walden Farms pancake syrup. Calorie-free, tastes fantastic. The ingredients, now there are artificial sweeteners in there, but if you are counting your calories, this was something I relied on heavily when I was on contest prep. Again, not the necessarily the best with respect to it not being natural, but it does taste almost identical to regular pancake syrup. It's going to save you a lot of calories. The next thing is swapping out your canned tuna. So swapping out your canned tuna for tuna in oil for tuna packed in water. You're going to save a lot of fat calories. Now, if you're on a ketogenic diet, it's not going to be that important, but if you are including carbs, you don't want to be in a situation where you're high carb and high fat together at the same time. So save yourself the fats and just go with the tuna based in water. Now, item number 5, this is going to sound really simple and basic, but I recommend eating on a smaller plate. Sometimes if you eat on a large plate versus a small plate, there's this like mental thing where it feels like you are getting a bigger portion than you actually are when you eat it on a smaller plate, versus if you eat your food on a big plate, it just feels like you're being deprived because your food might look sad on a big old plate. So item number 4, you guys, burger with the bun versus burger without the bun. This is something I do all the time when I go to restaurants where I'm ordering burgers. Always just get the burger without the bun. You're gonna save yourself a ton of carbs. Now, even if you are gonna get like some sweet potato fries with it, save yourself, my goodness, a solid 30, 40 grams of carbs by just skipping the bun, enjoying the burger, because it tastes really good as it is. And like I said, if you really need to get carbs, it's not too hard to find carbs, but just don't waste them on the bun. Item number 3 is swapping out sugar for cinnamon. So again, another way to sweeten your coffee, another way to flavor and jazz up your oatmeal is to use cinnamon instead of sugar. And cinnamon can actually naturally lower your blood glucose level. So it's a really, really great ingredient to have raw without sugar. Item number 2 is swapping out your mayo for some mustard. If you're like a big time sandwich person, I am not, but I know some people who are. Mustard is going to be a much healthier condiment compared to mayo. And item number 1, swapping out your diet sodas for coffee. Diet sodas, even though they are zero calorie, you guys, they still have just a lot of chemicals, a lot of heavy syrups, lots of things that you don't really need in your body. So if you're like a sugar-free Red Bull person, a Diet Coke person, a Diet Pepsi person, try swapping that out just for some black coffee. You can have iced coffee, black coffee, but it's gonna just be a cleaner, or tea, a cleaner, healthier product for you. So I hope these were helpful. Comment which ones you're gonna try and share this video with a friend. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one.